There's nothing that happens after the Haitian Revolution and our fight for freedom across the Caribbean and North and South America that wasn't influenced by the Haitian Revolution.
The African people on the island fought all the largest armies of the world at the time and won over each one of them. Whooped the Spaniards, beat up the French, knocked down the British.
The Haitians have a pride about them. The revolution is the most important thing to them. The first thing they instill in you is that you are the first Black Republic.
1804 becomes important because it's the date at which the implementation of the dream of real revolution and real equality and new nation status and the ability to defend your new nation is manifest.
When you look at modern historians, when they talk about victories that Europeans had over non-white people, they always frame the narrative as victories. But when African people rise up and fight off their European oppressors, they frame the narrative as a massacre.
Africans everywhere that were enslaved resisted it. Haiti becomes significant because it was the first time in human history that an enslaved population actually overthrew their oppressors.
The Haitian Revolution, though, was the most organized, the most large scale, the most impressive in terms of structure and complication from the very beginning.
Haiti made more money for France than all 13 colonies.
The Haitian Revolution was very influential, particularly amongst Africans. It was seen as an inspiration for Africans in this hemisphere, just as it was seen as a horror by those who held slavery dear.
There is a concept that we must defeat Haiti. We must ground them into the ground. We can never let them rise. They are an example of Black power. They are an example of what happens when people who are oppressed decide to stop being oppressed.
Vache is one of the world's most beautiful islands, kissed by the warm waters of the Caribbean Sea. Located on the southwest coast of Haiti, it is 30 minutes by boat from the city of Lekai, the third largest city. This piece of land is a paradise, where years ago, Captain Sir Henry Morgan and the Pirates of the Caribbean buried their treasure. Covering an area of nearly 45 square kilometers, the island is made up of mountains, forests, mangroves, coral reefs, and more than 20 beaches. Ila Vache still retains its natural purity. There are no cars anywhere on the island. Its 15,000 inhabitants have basic lives of fishing and agriculture that are the basis of the island's economy. The Haitian government has set its sights on Ila Vache for a large-scale, sustainable eco-adventure tourism project. The Ministry of Tourism has plans to turn it into an upscale tourist destination. The plan includes 2,000 to 3,000 new beds in bungalows and small hotels, all the required infrastructures, including solar mill energy and 1,000 hectares for biological agriculture. The island will soon feature a 4C category airport with a 2,600 meter runway and terminal, boutique hotels and chalets facing the sea, a leisure area with restaurants and art galleries, a service area with community and hospital schools, a marina, an underwater museum, tropical botanical garden, and a professional diving center. In addition, the government will create a farm to serve visitors in the community, improve pedestrian routes, develop a network of public transportation, renewable energy, and other basic infrastructure, such as the supply of water and roads. The government will also set up vocational training for young people. The goal is to create a new destination to provide an authentic experience for travelers in search of adventure. For the Martelly Lamotte administration, the development of tourism is one of the most important tools to stimulate economic growth in Haiti. Tourism is an economic engine that will result in the creation of new jobs and provide new revenue to the state. That way, the government can increase the social benefits and improve living conditions for all the Haitian people. The tourism development project in Île aux Vaches is proof of the commitment we have always shown to the people of our country. Haiti, live the experience.
He's obviously not an Olympic diver. Neither is he a champion swimmer. He's not a professional rock climber. He's not trying to establish a new record. He's just having fun. But where is this place? Obviously, on a Caribbean island. Waterfall, lush vegetation, blue water. Could it be Cuba, Jamaica, Trinidad or Martinique? No, it is Haiti.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. I go by the name of Freedom, also known as the Voice of the People. Haiti is one of the most beautiful places in the world, but most people have no idea about the breathtaking, majestic energy that exists here. I'm from Cape Haitian. That's the city that created freedom. The Citadel and Sanssouci Palace are two extraordinary examples of what took place in this town. They are iconic monuments in Haiti and are also recognized as UNESCO World Heritage Sites. The Citadel has the largest collection of 18th century cannons and cannonballs in the world. Palais Sanssouci was the royal residence of King Henri Christophe and Queen Marie Louise. It was the most important palace out of all that were built under his name. In 1982, the the Citadel was recognized as World Heritage by the UNESCO. Its construction included elements such as lime, molasses, and blood. Animals were sacrificed and their blood was spilled on the walls under construction. Some say it's how they worshiped the gods and spirits of the voodoo religion for the proper protection of its structure. In the year 1804, the independence of Haiti was declared, and Haiti became the first black republic in the world to obtain its independence.
Several places to visit, a bar, restaurant in Cape Haitien, but La Caille happens to be the best location. And when you come there at night, a number of people, that it, all the mission, everybody comes to La Caille restaurant. It's still early, but in the evening, there's all kinds of people here. Don't forget, when you come to Cap Haitien, stop by La Caille restaurant located on the boulevard in Cape Haitien, Haiti. You will love it.
I met this guy, this is a vlogger actually, and I met him in DR, and by coincidence, we meet in Laval the exact day, exact time.
It's crazy.
This is crazy.
It's not casual. So,
La Amiga Island, como conocida como Isla Rat, o Isla Rata.
This is a remarkable island, Isla Rat, and when you come with us, you can have the entire island for yourself. Come on, let's go.
Hi, my name is Princess Earth. I am an artist, and I also design clothes with Caribbean and African flair to highlight the beauty of my culture. Let me tell you a bit about Bassin Zima. It is located in Plateau Central, 8 kilometers from the city of Hench. It contains waterfalls, coves, and caves. Its caves contain artwork by the indigenous Taino Indians before colonization. Despite how cold the water temperature is there, everyone who visits this place always jumps in. Definitely a place to visit.
Ça c'est la caille. This is what the media is not showing you.
Bonjour mon cher Dao, je t'y en invite, oui, nous n'avons pas place ou dans la cour, la cour, la cour. C'est son liberté, nous, que son bac à partenir, ni son là dans la cour, la cour, la cour.
Bonjour mon cher Dao, freedom, freedom.
peut-être ça qui a marché, pour que nous comprenions que nous-mêmes nous voulons vivre quand même.
Hi everybody, my name is Tony Louis. I'm a visual artist and hip-hop artist. I created Jatao. He's a Haitian superhero who fights crime all around the world, especially in Azuéville, the new capital of Haiti. Of course, it's fictional. It's inside the graphic novels that I've been publishing in Haiti and in different Comic-Cons in the United States. But today I'm here to present you La Gonave. La Gonave is an island of Haiti, located in the west northwest of Port-au-Prince. The island covers an area of 287 square miles, about two-thirds of Martinique Island. It is the largest island of Haiti and contains two towns, Ansagale and Pointe Araquette. Ansagale is the largest site of the island.
Give me one figure with my friend.
This is the non-populated side of Gonave. The other side is more populated. This is where they have the main cities.
Surrounded with crystal clear waters, this island is the perfect getaway destination.
Bananier plus belle, parce que là où nos plages ont marché depuis rivage en niveau jusqu'en bas, ils sont sous genou. Bon, chaque plage a une différence, yo, chaque monde a un choix. Haïti chérie, plus belle quand même.
Yeah.
It's hard to get the words. You got that good, that black magic, that hypnotic voodoo you do.
You put a spell on me. I can't control my body, babe. You put a spell on me. I can't resist your body.
You got that good, that black magic, that hypnotic.
My boyfriend and I are currently traveling the world on our sailboat and are sharing our adventures on our YouTube channel, Sailing Uma. I want to thank Pat Felice for reaching out to us. We are honored to be part of such an amazing project. We recently spent 6 months exploring the wonders of Haiti. And today I want to share with you a glimpse of our journey to one of our favorite waterfalls, Cascade Pichon.
After a two-hour boat ride, an hour and a half of bumping up the road on a motorcycle, and another hour of hiking, we finally made it to the most beautiful waterfall we've ever seen in Haiti. Cascade Pichon is one of the most difficult falls to get to, but when we got there, we instantly forgot the hard 6 hours of travel. At least a dozen jaw-dropping waterfalls are fed by an underground lake at the top of the mountain. Haiti definitely has its own character. But after we spend the time to truly see her real beauty, we begin to realize how Haiti's unique natural elements have the potential to surpass the negativity, masking her true allure, and that ecotourism may be the future of this country. Thank you.
I know, right? I bet you've never seen those images of Haiti. As Miss Haiti, I wanted to show you the side of the country that the media does not reveal. How beautiful, raw, and breathtaking our land truly is. Haiti is too rich to be poor. This is Haiti. This is the Haiti that I know.
This is Haiti.
La caille, c'est la caille.
Ça, c'est Haiti, Pamela.